How's it going, my brothers and sisters? It's your boy, the Island Boys, and I'm coming at you guys with the updated tier list for all of the Mortal Kombat games. Now that Mortal Kombat 11 is officially over, except for the Combat Pack 3 trailer that just came out. No, I'm kidding. I hope you guys actually enjoyed it, that Combat Pack 3 trailer that I made. If you guys have not seen it, go take a look. I'll be leaving a link right on the corner over there if you guys want to go take a look. But now that Mortal Kombat 11 is officially over, I'm gonna go over a tier list for all of the Mortal Kombat games. I'm not going to be incorporating Mortal Kombat Gold. That could be on the bottom. I'm not gonna incorporate Mortal Kombat Game Boy Advance Edition. I'm not going to be incorporating, is there a Mortal Kombat Dead or Deception Unchained? No, okay. I won't be incorporating those two games. So let me just go ahead and sort all these games out from first to last. So the lowest tier, it's obviously going to have to be Mortal Kombat Special Forces. They decided to go with a third-person kind of shooter game. I didn't really like it. It was a story covering Jax and the Special Forces. Wasn't really a great game whatsoever. Was very bored whenever I played this game. I even tried to go back and play it recently, and I just couldn't. I just could not. It was just such a bad game, and I actually believe that John Tobias left midway through, and no pun intended, midway through creating this game. And next up on that list, that's also on the bottom, but it's above Special Forces, has to be Mortal Kombat Mythologies Sub-Zero. And again, one of those games where Mortal Kombat decided to not go the original traditional route of their fighting game, and they decided to go with a Special Forces kind of take, but this time involving Sub-Zero. Again, just another game where the combos were just way too long to perform. They just really didn't seem to get a grasp or get a handle on creating a third-person non-traditional fighting game. It just did not work out, but there was one game that they did make a couple years later that actually did a very good job, and I'm pretty sure you guys know which game that is. All right, next up, we're going to be going over the C tier list. I don't believe there's any other games on this list that are going to make it onto the bottom of D list as a failure list, but next on C, we're going to go, I'm going to put Mortal Kombat 4 down there, and I know this is not the traditional route. A lot of people would decide to go and put in Mortal Kombat versus DC Universe, but I'll explain. This was the period in time where Mortal Kombat and Midway, they were trying to transition into the 3D era fighting games. Switching over to the 3D era game, it was just not it. There were a lot of silly fatalities. There were a lot of silly storylines for the character ending stories. A lot of memes came from this game. Wasn't the greatest. It was a good step into their 3D era games, but they definitely did a much better job down the line. That's why I have to put it so low on this list. At the time, they did a good job switching over to 3D era, although there's a lot of memes that came from this game and it wasn't the best. They did a good job at the time, but there were a lot of games later on that improved on the mechanics of the 3D era games for sure. Okay, so next up on this list, I'm gonna put Mortal Kombat versus DC Universe at C above Mortal Kombat 4, but honestly might reach B tier. I remember as a kid when this game first came out, I was so excited to play this. Mortal Kombat versus DC Universe. Two of my favorite things, two of the biggest properties from Warner Brothers, and they're going head to head, fighting each other, and it's gonna be super gory, super awesome, super gruesome. I can't wait to see the fatalities. What's the story gonna be like? I was really hyped to play this game. It was another 3D era installment for Mortal Kombat, and it was such an awesome idea, such an awesome concept to put these characters fighting against each other. I remember I got the game, I was playing it, and I was definitely disappointed. There were some great things about this game, but there were some terrible things about this game as well. Like I said, it was great to see Batman versus Scorpion, seeing Sub-Zero, seeing Wonder Woman, seeing Superman, seeing all of these awesome characters go head to head. Mortal Kombat is known for their fatalities. It's known for how gruesome it is. And once they decided to throw in DC Universe characters, it got less gory, and you couldn't do a lot of these things because they were targeting a different audience. They were targeting more younger kids. They couldn't do a bunch of the rated R, rated M for mature things in Mortal Kombat that they could do in Mortal Kombat versus DC Universe. So a lot of the fatalities were really watered down, but they really had some awesome and cool ideas in this game. Another cool feature that they brought to Mortal Kombat versus DC Universe was the Test Your Might ability. So when two characters were fighting against each other and they got punched off the map, both characters were spamming, you know, trying to do the Test Your Might to take less damage or to make the opponent take more damage. It was a really cool concept. Don't know if I would like that to come back into future Mortal Kombat games, But it was very cool. I definitely did like that idea. The only thing I didn't like was the fact that a lot of the fatalities were watered down. I wish the character roster was a little bit bigger. I was very surprised that Johnny Cage, Kung Lao, Quan Chi, all those guys didn't make it into the roster. Fun fact, there were actually a couple characters that Ed Boon hinted that were going to come to the game as DLC, and those characters were Kung Lao, Doomsday, and I believe Harley Quinn and Quan Chi. Those four characters, I believe, were supposed to be rumored to come to the game, but they couldn't make DLC at the time, so they weren't put into the game. But like I said, this game was great, had some pros, had some cons. I might put it up to B tier because of the idea and the concept, but it might stay a C above Mortal Kombat 4 for right now. All right, going to B tier, or actually, it might actually drop to C tier, is Mortal Kombat Armageddon. Now, this game might go above Mortal Kombat versus DC Universe. It actually might stay as B tier right here. And there's a lot of reasons why. Mortal Kombat and Midway, they were approaching the end of the 3D era games. They were approaching the end of Mortal Kombat. We had Mortal Kombat Deadly Alliance, we had Mortal Kombat Deception, we had Mortal Kombat Shaolin Monks, and then it was Mortal Kombat Armageddon, the finale of the 3D era games. And this game was supposed to be the end all be all for Mortal Kombat. It was it was over, and you're supposed to end on a good note, and it did not end on a good note whatsoever. Was kind of disappointed, and I know a lot of my subscribers and a lot of my followers grew up playing Mortal Kombat Armageddon as one of their first games, but as someone who has played Mortal Kombat 1, Mortal Kombat 2, Mortal Kombat 3, every single Mortal Kombat game, I can almost guarantee you that right here Armageddon belongs on B tier, and honestly it might even go lower to C tier in my opinion. Now let me explain why. Mortal Kombat Armageddon, an insanely huge roster. Kind of like Mortal Kombat Trilogy, right? With a huge roster, you won't be able to get all of the cool things that you got in previous Mortal Kombat games, or the necessary things that you got in other Mortal Kombat games. For example, in Mortal Kombat Deception, characters had three different movesets. In Mortal Kombat Armageddon, with the insanely huge roster, they dropped that down to two fighting styles. Another thing that they dropped down was the fatalities. Now, Mortal Kombat is known for their fatalities, right? They're known for how gruesome the fatalities are. They're known for how gory the fighting game is in general. And in Mortal Kombat Armageddon, they created a create your own fatality, which was kind of weird. I didn't like it whatsoever. And it wasn't every character had some amazing fatality, their own unique fatality. It was kind of this custom press a button fatality, and it did not work well, and I know the community did not like that whatsoever. But this is what happens when you get an insanely huge roster. They had to cut back on some of the necessary things that were in other Mortal Kombat games. Yes, they gave us motor combat. Yes, they gave us a conquest, and yes, they did give us a create a character. But a lot of the movesets for every single character on that roster had to be dialed back a bit. There were less moves, the movesets were kind of dry, and the other characters were kind of just copied and pasted from Deadly Alliance, from Deception, into Armageddon. They didn't have any new movesets whatsoever, they were just kind of copied, pasted. There wasn't really anything new about it. It was just, here's every single character, we're gonna throw it all to you guys, and I'm sure you guys are gonna love it because we're giving you guys every single character. There may be fewer movesets, you might not even have your own fatality, but we'll give you motor combat and we'll give you a conquest. To me, I would much rather have those characters have their own movesets, be very unique, have their own fatalities, and take away the motor combat and take away the conquest. I would totally be fine with that. If they improved on the aspects of the fighting game itself, I think Mortal Kombat Armageddon would have been up at A tier or maybe even S tier. But for the fact that they had to dial everything back a bit because of the fact that they had to put so much time into all of the characters, putting everything in there, it kind of made the game a little bit less than it should have been. Hopefully that makes sense. Hopefully I explained it the best I could possibly explain it. And when I get to the other games that are above Mortal Kombat Armageddon, maybe you can understand where I'm coming from. I gotta get some water on that one. That was a lot of talking. Okay, moving on to the next game. I'm going to put Mortal Kombat 3 on B tier. With Mortal Kombat 3, I'll have to explain this. I know there's a lot of diehard Mortal Kombat 3 fans because it was the original trilogy, the original timeline of Mortal Kombat games, the original three arcade Mortal Kombat games, Mortal Kombat 1, Mortal Kombat 2, Mortal Kombat 3. From Mortal Kombat 1 to Mortal Kombat 2, insane jump. For what they did from graphics to style to gameplay to characters, an insane jump. Mortal Kombat 2 was so amazing. Then the jump from Mortal Kombat 2 to Mortal Kombat 3. very different jump, very interesting jump between the two games. Very fast-paced game, and I loved that a lot. The graphics, amazing. I loved that a lot too. Just the whole style of the game was amazing. There was only one thing wrong with it, or a few things wrong with it, I should say. Number one, the roster. It was an interesting take from Midway. They kind of went the separate route. They didn't focus on the main characters of the game. They introduced some new characters, but also put in some characters that no one really played as much. They didn't bring back Scorpion. They didn't bring back Raiden. They didn't bring back Reptile. They didn't bring back Kitana. There were a lot of characters that were not brought back from the original Mortal Kombat 1 and Mortal Kombat 2 game. There were a lot of characters that were not brought back into Mortal Kombat 3, and a lot of people were going crazy about that. They were like, why aren't these characters brought in? However, Mortal Kombat 3 did a lot of great things. Like I said, the fast-paced movement, the graphics, the ability to run was insane. Like I said, how fast-paced this game was, the ability to run was so damn cool. The ability to perform combos, like the combo chains was introduced, and that was really awesome as well. And the ways to unlock things were really cool. The stages were really awesome as well. But I think it was definitely, those things were overshadowed because of the fact that there were many characters that weren't brought back into Mortal Kombat 3, and a lot of people were really disappointed about that fact. All right, the next game, I think I'm gonna have to move over to A tier now, and it's gonna be Mortal Kombat 3, or Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3, I should say. Now, when talking about Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3, this is where a lot of people were like, yes, this is what we wanted. This is everything we could ask for. Now, like I said, this game was an update from Mortal Kombat 3. So there was a lot of things that they improved upon, like the character roster. They included Reptile, Melina, Scorpion, Noob Saibot, Cyber Smoke, Human Smoke. I don't know if Raiden was in that roster or not. I'm not too sure, but I know that Johnny Cage did not make a return. And again, a lot of people were saying, why isn't Johnny Cage in the game? Like, they brought back these many characters, why not Johnny Cage? Which was another thing, like I said, in Mortal Kombat versus DC Universe, they didn't bring in Johnny Cage, which was very interesting. I don't know why Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3 did not bring in Johnny Cage, but they improved on characters, they improved on gameplay mechanics. It was such a fast-paced, amazing game. They introduced more classic maps and classic stages. Overall, amazing game. Has to be put on A, but it's another reason, like how Mortal Kombat 4 is kind of put at C. It was a great game at the time, for then what came after, what they improved upon, puts Mortal Kombat 4 to shame, like how it kind of, not to shame, I guess it is, for in Mortal Kombat 4's case, it puts it to shame, but with Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3, it doesn't put it to shame, but it just improves upon that game a little bit better. Next up on the A tier, we're going to put Mortal Kombat Deadly Alliance, and this game might go under Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3. It might go over Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3. Not too sure. These two actually might go side by side. I'm not quite too sure just yet. Mortal Kombat Deadly Alliance. This definitely improved upon Mortal Kombat 4. This game introduced two new fighting styles for each character, which was really cool to see. The maps were awesome. The graphics were amazing. They really improved upon Mortal Kombat 4 and the 3D era transition. This is where Midway started to make their way into the 3D era games for Mortal Kombat, and they did a phenomenal job with this. This story mode, oh my goodness. When you first start the game, you don't even press any button yet, and you already find out that Liu Kang has died. Shang Tsung kills him. He snaps his neck. As a kid, when I was growing up, I was like, what? They killed Liu Kang? Like, what is going on here? And then I see Quan Chi and Shang Tsung team up, and I'm like, what is going on? They're teaming up here? What is this? And it was just such an interesting story. I remember, I can just hear it now in my mind. I can just hear the soundtrack of when you're selecting your character, when you're on that roster. I remember genuinely being scared of Shang Tsung and Quan Chi. As a kid, I genuinely was scared of looking at those characters. Listening to the music, it really got my blood pumping. I was just really excited and also really scared to play this game. This game definitely was a step up from Mortal Kombat 4 and definitely set the standards for the 3D era games. Next up on our A tier list has to be Mortal Kombat. Now this game, it's tough. When you start to get into the A and the S tier list, it starts to get tough where to actually put them. I wanna put maybe Mortal Kombat towards the bottom of A tier, and mostly because, yes, it started everything we know about Mortal Kombat and about fighting games. Oh, sorry, I was about to burp. Ugh, goodness. Okay, anyway, back to the story. It started everything with fighting games. It was one of a kind. It was its own kind of fighting game. It got everybody talking about Mortal Kombat. Everybody was talking about Mortal Kombat when this game dropped. There were a lot of stuff legally going on. It was court cases. It had everyone talking about Mortal Kombat. And it's so interesting to see how the culture was back then, because at that time, that was something so gruesome and so horrible that it literally had to go to court, because it was, people were that outraged about the game, and they set the bar for every single fighting game. It was ridiculous. And just to know how far Mortal Kombat has come now, and just in general, how gruesome some games are now, it just shocks me what that would have been like if we took Mortal Kombat 11 right now, Mortal Kombat 9, Mortal Kombat X, and we put that game back then to when Mortal Kombat 1 officially came out. Imagine the outrage that would have happened back then. It would have been so insane, worse than what Mortal Kombat went through. And you go back and you play Mortal Kombat now and you're like, this is what everyone was getting upset about? It's so insane how culture has changed since Mortal Kombat 1 dropped. Okay, now we're gonna move into S tier. And this is gonna be a large S tier list, guys. And you guys are gonna be like, what the heck? Why does he have so many games on S tier? It's because they all have something very unique about them. And I'm gonna try put it in order on S tier, but it's gonna be really hard. But there are a lot of games on this list that deserve S tier. And I've been doing a lot of thinking. I've been trying to keep as much bias as I can out of this tier list. And I feel like I've been doing a solid job. Thinking about it now, a lot of these Mortal Kombat games, even though they get shit on by the community so much, a lot of these games deserve S tier. So let's get into this. Coming in at the bottom spot of S tier is going to be Mortal Kombat 2. Mortal Kombat 2, like I said, the jump from Mortal Kombat to Mortal Kombat 2 was insane. This game introduced a lot of fan favorite characters like Melina, Katana, Kung Lao. It introduced the Deadpool map. You can fight against Shao Kahn now. The gameplay mechanics are so much better. It was a lot more vibrant. It wasn't just your ordinary gory fighting game like how Mortal Kombat was. This was leaps and bounds of perfection over Mortal Kombat 1, and it definitely deserves the S tier spot. They definitely did an amazing job. I'm gonna go with Mortal Kombat Shaolin Monks as the next one. Mortal Kombat Shaolin Monks as the second to last spot on S tier. Another game from Midway that did not go your typical route for your average Mortal Kombat fighting game. They tried that with Mythology Sub-Zero. They tried that with Special Forces. And now they tried it again with Shaolin Monks. This time you're following a story with Kung Lao and Liu Kang. It's a co-op game. It's another third-person fighting game. It is so damn cool. The gameplay mechanics were awesome. The costume design was amazing. The story was amazing. And I just really, really wish they would make a Shaolin Monks 2. And I think it would be a great starting point if they maybe went with the story after Mortal Kombat 11 is over and you're seeing Fire God Liu Kang going back to the Great Kung Lao. And maybe that could be Shaolin Monks Part 2. That would be such an awesome game. I would drop so much money if that game came out. Or even make a Mortal Kombat, I don't know, like maybe Sub-Zero and Scorpion. Like something like Shaolin Monks but with Sub-Zero and Scorpion. Oh my, I know for a fact that if NetherRealm came out with a Shaolin Monks Part 2, so many people would drop so much money on that. I know it for a fact. I just do not know why they haven't dropped it yet. I'm just very confused why they have not dropped it yet. Mortal Kombat X. I might have to say Mortal Kombat X, guys. And here's why. A lot of people are probably thinking right now, why he's gonna put Mortal Kombat 11 over Mortal Kombat X? Is this guy dumb? I'll explain. Mortal Kombat X was such an amazing game. Arguably has probably the best DLC that any Mortal Kombat game has ever had. I'm not gonna lie, in my opinion, it is the best DLC that any Mortal Kombat game has ever had. The amount, we had Leatherface, Jason, Alien, Predator, Tanya, Boraicho, Triborg, Goro. I could go on and on about how amazing this DLC was for Mortal Kombat X. And I was very disappointed about the DLC we got in Mortal Kombat 11 compared to Mortal Kombat X, how amazing and how hyped that game was. It was a letdown for Mortal Kombat 11, but I'll explain why I think Mortal Kombat 11 is a slightly better game than Mortal Kombat X later. Fast-paced gameplay of Mortal Kombat X was amazing. It was weird how sometimes the characters were really shiny. I don't know why that was, but sometimes they were like, they looked really wet or really shiny. It was kind of weird, but it was kind of cool at the same time. There were a lot of new characters that were introduced into Mortal Kombat X that I actually liked. Now, usually when Mortal Kombat introduces characters in the past, I didn't really like them that much, you know? But this time in Mortal Kombat X, they introduced a lot of new characters like Jackie Briggs, Kung Jin, Takeda, Cassie Cage, Ferritor, Devorah, Aaron Black. There were a lot of new characters. I might be even missing some few new characters, but those characters that were introduced into Mortal Kombat X were actually really cool. They did a really good job explaining their story, having them in the story. Their gameplay was really cool. All the mechanics were awesome. Like I said, the gameplay and the mechanics from Mortal Kombat X were really cool. I'm more of a fast-paced kind of guy when it comes to like fighting games, and Mortal Kombat X perfected that. They did a really amazing job with doing new things with fighting styles, where they had the three different variations for each character. That was really cool. The costume design and everything for Mortal Kombat X characters were really awesome as well. The crypt was amazing. Overall, they did an amazing job for Mortal Kombat X. But I really do think that there are a couple games that are better than Mortal Kombat X. And the next game that comes into mind is Mortal Kombat 11. Arguably one of the most beautiful, not even arguably, it is the most beautiful Mortal Kombat game that has ever been made. The graphics on this game is absolutely ridiculously good. They did such an amazing job with this game, the graphics and everything. The gameplay. I'm a fan of fast-paced gameplay. Mortal Kombat 11 isn't fast-paced. Mortal Kombat 11 introduced a lot of new things that made it unique. And the reason why I have a lot of these games on S tier is because they all bring something unique and valuable to their own game, right? Mortal Kombat 11 introduced something that we've never seen before. It introduced breakaways, it introduced get-up attacks, it introduced rolls, it introduced crushing blows, and it introduced fatal blows, okay? There were a lot of new things in Mortal Kombat 11 that make it so superior to other games, right? And even customization, the amount of customization that we had in Mortal Kombat 11 was ridiculous. Now, the con to that was, even though there was a lot of customization, some of the skins, or a lot of the skins in that game, were very bland and very boring. Me personally, I would rather have less customization that have cooler designs than more customization that are bland designs, if that makes any sense. Like, each character had around 20 to 25 plus customization looks when it came to gear, it came to outfits and suits and all that, but a lot of them were just really bland, and you kind of get bored of all those bland, like a lot of them were just kind of palette swap colors, and it's like, okay, a lot of them are kind of bland, they're just palette swap. I'm looking for something that pops and stands out. Like MKX had something that popped, it stood out. Like Raiden had some crazy designs, like Future Raiden and MKX, holy moly. Dark Raiden and MKX, they had some crazy designs. Although he had maybe 4 to 5 different outfits, they were all super crazy, and I love every single one of Raiden's outfits in Mortal Kombat X. However, the reason why Mortal Kombat is better than Mortal Kombat X is because of the fact that we have all this customization. We have all these different unique abilities to unlock stuff like the crypt. They have perfected the crypt. In MK11, they perfected the crypt, and I stand by that. The crypt was so amazing, it literally reminded me of Conquest, okay? They perfected the crypt. I do wish that it wasn't randomized though, because I remember spending hours in the crypt trying to unlock a certain gear or certain item for a certain character, and my friend would literally unlock it as soon as he gets in the game. Like, he would spend 2 seconds, unlocks it. Me, I'd spend an hour trying to unlock a certain thing for my character, couldn't find it, you know? I wish it wasn't randomized, and I wish that's one thing that they would go back to in Mortal Kombat 12, is that they would keep things where they belong in the crypt and not have it randomized. Maybe the shrine, if they're going to introduce the shrine in Mortal Kombat 12, keep that randomized. That's totally fine if that's randomized. I don't care. But where the items are and the loots and the crates and everything, do not keep those randomized. That's so annoying. Sometimes it took me hours to find one thing for my character. Or my friend would go in there and he'd be like, damn, what? I got something for Scorpion or Sonya. Damn, I don't want this. And I was like, bro, you just got into the crypt. I've been in here for hours and I have not found a single thing for my character. That was annoying. But nonetheless, they perfected the crypt. It looked absolutely beautiful. DLC, like I said, I hated the DLC. Or I didn't hate, I shouldn't say hate. They had really cool characters. Terminator, Spawn, Joker, really awesome. I know a lot of people wanted Ash Williams, but you know, I kind of liked Joker, Terminator, and Spawn. Although I don't use Terminator that much, I like the idea and the concept of him being in a Mortal Kombat game, if that makes sense. It's a pretty cool idea, right? You know, just thinking about all these characters that could make it into a Mortal Kombat fighter game, it's really cool to see, you know, head to head, who would win, Terminator or Spawn, Alien or Predator. It's really cool to see these characters come to life in a Mortal Kombat game. They might not be my personal favorites, but it's really cool to see them into a Mortal Kombat game. I did not like the fact that we got Shiva again. Now I'll explain why. Mortal Kombat 9, we got Shiva. Mortal Kombat X, we got Goro. Both four-armed creatures, Shokans, right? Mortal Kombat 11, I was expecting that we got Kentaro, because I thought they were going to, you know, keep along the same path of four-armed characters. But they brought back Shiva. I really wish they would have brought in Kentaro. I think that would have upped the roster by 20 million points, you know, because we got Goro in MKX. That was awesome. If they brought Kentaro into MK11, that would have been really awesome to see too, because we haven't seen Kentaro in ages. It was awesome to see Rain make an appearance. He did make an appearance in Mortal Kombat 9, but it was awesome to see him make an appearance in Mortal Kombat 11. I do wish that we got Reptile and Ermac, because they wasted a design on Ermac in the crypt and didn't bring him into the game. Me personally, I wouldn't care if they took out Shiva and they put in Ermac. I wouldn't care, honestly, if they took out Fujin either. I wasn't really a big fan of Fujin. I know there's a lot of diehard Fujin fans out there, but I just wasn't ever really a fan. He's a cool character, but honestly, if I had to pick, I wouldn't mind if Fujin got taken out and Smoke got put into the game. I would much rather have Smoke over Fujin. I'm just speaking facts here, people. But nonetheless, Fujin was cool to come in. I just didn't really like that little combat pack that we got for Aftermath. I mean, I love that they added on a story. Oh, that's another thing. They literally added a whole other story into Mortal Kombat 11. It was like a whole other game. It was literally like a whole other game, because it was $40 damn. That was expensive. But we got friendships. We got new maps. We got three new characters. Although I didn't like those three characters, RoboCop, Shiva, Fujin. I think that was kind of a waste of characters. But we still got them nonetheless. We got friendships. We got all these cool things in the game. And then we also got the Mortal Kombat 9 Scorpion and the Mortal Kombat Deception Sub-Zero. All these cool things, right? All of these things that were added into Mortal Kombat 11 made it so superior than all these other games. They put so much time and effort into Mortal Kombat 11 than any other game. Now let's move on to gameplay. Like I said, I'm a kind of person that prefers a fast-paced gameplay. Mortal Kombat 11, much slower. Has a lot of different new strategies and techniques. And that's what I think is the difference between Mortal Kombat 11, Mortal Kombat X. It's a much more strategic game. It's not a bunch of 50-50s like Mortal Kombat X was. Mortal Kombat 11 is much more strategic if you don't count the zoning, okay? If you don't count the zoning, it's a much more strategic game. You have to figure out, is your opponent gonna wake up? Is your opponent gonna roll? Is your opponent gonna break out? I do not like the breakouts at all. I would prefer that it would just be a breaker and you go back to neutral like how it was in Mortal Kombat X, Mortal Kombat 9. I prefer that by a long shot. But I'm talking about uniqueness here and what it brought to the table. Although good and bad, I do think that Mortal Kombat X and Mortal Kombat 9 fighting and gameplay style is better than Mortal Kombat 11. But when I'm talking about uniqueness, what it brought to the table, this definitely is superior to all the other Mortal Kombat games, Mortal Kombat X, Shaolin Monks, Mortal Kombat 2, everything below this list, okay? So I think that's why Mortal Kombat 11 deserves a spot at the S tier list, because of all those reasons. And I think those are some pretty solid reasons. It's not my personal favorite Mortal Kombat 11 game. I would much rather play Mortal Kombat X over Mortal Kombat 11, but that's just because I have a bias towards MKX. I just like the fast-paced movement. I like all that kind of stuff. I like how dark it is. I like how gritty it is. It's a much more Mortal Kombat kind of feel to it. But I'm talking about what everything it brings to the table. Mortal Kombat 11 is a superior game to Mortal Kombat X. Like I said, not my personal favorite. I'd much rather play Mortal Kombat X, but it definitely is superior to Mortal Kombat X though. Okay, moving on to the next game. I'm gonna have to put Mortal Kombat Deception as the next spot in the top three. This is my top three now, ladies and gentlemen. Top three, Deception is definitely, Okay, this might be an easy one. Deception and Mortal Kombat 9 might be interchangeable, but I'll explain Deception first. So Deception as number three. When talking about uniqueness, creativity, and what this game brings to the table, out of the 3D era games from Mortal Kombat 4 to Mortal Kombat Armageddon, Deception is the best one. It is the best one by a long shot. Now, I know Earlier in the video, I was telling you guys, hey, I know you guys grew up on Mortal Kombat Armageddon. That was probably your first game that you guys played. A lot of my followers and subscribers tell me that Mortal Kombat Armageddon was the game that they played. That's the game that they grew up on. That was their first Mortal Kombat game. And that's totally fine. That's not really a bad start, but it's not the greatest start. Mortal Kombat Deception puts Mortal Kombat Armageddon to shame. To shame. Mortal Kombat Deception improves upon Deadly Alliance by a long shot, okay? Deadly Alliance, like I said, introduced two new fighting styles, right? Deception introduces three. So now you get three new fighting styles for each different character. Each character now has two fatalities, where in Mortal Kombat Deadly Alliance, you only had one fatality for each character. Deception, oh my gosh, I'm getting them mixed up. Deception now introduces two fatalities. Deadly Alliance had one fatality and two movesets. Deception has three movesets and two fatalities for each character. So it improves upon all the characters and gameplay and game mechanics by a long shot. By a long shot, okay? The story for Deception was so cool. It takes off right after Deadly Alliance. Like I said, you don't even push a button and you get this beautiful cinematic intro with Shang Tsung and Quan Chi just going at it. They're fighting each other. Raiden's there too. They're all going head to head. Shang Tsung and Quan Chi end up defeating Raiden. Then they betray each other because they're so power hungry. And then Onaga is introduced. And Onaga is just this powerhouse. There's a beast that comes in. Quan Chi is trying to fight Onaga by himself. Then Shang Tsung somehow just comes to life. He's not even dead. I don't know how. Quan Chi literally grabbed his neck and pretty much snapped it. And that man had blood coming out of his mouth. I don't know how he was alive after all that. But Shang Tsung stands up and he starts trying to fight Onaga with Quan Chi. And then all of a sudden, Raiden comes back to life. And I'm like, how the heck is this possible? And all three of them are now trying to fight Onaga. But he's so damn powerful that they cannot defeat him. And then Raiden says, screw it. And he decides to blow up everybody. He kills himself. He kills Quan Chi. He kills Shang Tsung. He blows up everything. And that, like, it was like an atomic bomb that drops. And Onaga still does not die. That man is still alive. And he picks up the amulet. And he's like, yeah, I'm about to literally rule over every single world. Every single realm, right? And then we're introduced to the conquest mode. And we're introduced to Shujinko. And that man, I don't know why they haven't brought Shujinko back into the Mortal Kombat franchise or into the newer Mortal Kombat games. We get to see him once in Cassie Cage's ending of Mortal Kombat X. I believe she kills him, actually. He might be dead. Yeah, that kind of sucks. But I remember playing as in Conquest. Oh my, dude, the Conquest mode in Deception was so damn amazing. They did a phenomenal job with that conquest mode. Not only did we get conquest, but we also got puzzle combat and we also got chess combat. Like, what? Like, this game went above and beyond. It had so many unique things for Mortal Kombat. It was definitely the best 3D era game and one of the best Mortal Kombat games ever made. Coming in at number two, we have Mortal Kombat 9. Now, this was the first installment from NetherRealm Studios creating their version of Mortal Kombat. And holy moly, this game was so damn amazing. The story was so cool. It was basically just Mortal Kombat 1 to Mortal Kombat 3. That's basically what it was. That's what Mortal Kombat 9's story was. It kind of was like this restart of the timeline, but it also was the same exact thing from Mortal Kombat 1 to Mortal Kombat 3. The graphics, amazing for its time. It was so amazing. The gameplay mechanics, it introduced so many new gameplay mechanics. The X-ray, the move enhancements, literally so many cool things from Mortal Kombat 9 was introduced. And the best part about it was the combos. They introduced such a unique combo ability in Mortal Kombat. It's so amazing. It's so good. I've had such a hard time playing other fighting games because I love the mechanic and the combo of Mortal Kombat so much. From Mortal Kombat 9, it's made it so hard to play any other fighting game for me. I just love it so much. The costumes, amazing. Arguably, I think Deception had probably the best, like the 3D era games probably had the best costume designs, but Mortal Kombat 9 definitely had, if not the best, the second best costume designs for all the Mortal Kombat characters by far. One thing that I am so ashamed in NetherRealm Studios for not bringing back is 2v2s. Tag team. What the heck, NetherRealm? Why have you guys not brought back 2v2s? I've heard from Ed Boon that he said himself that that game mode was actually not very popular, like not that many people played it. And I'm like, what? How is that even possible? Like, I literally remember going over to my friend's house every single time we played Mortal Kombat, we'd be doing 2v2s. every single time. Every single time it was 2v2s or just playing 1v1s. Obviously 1v1 because that's what Mortal Kombat is. But I'm very shocked that they have not brought back 2v2s or tag team yet. Imagine the tournaments for tag team in today's gaming industry. Imagine if Mortal Kombat 11 had tag team. Imagine if Mortal Kombat X had tag team. Mortal Kombat 9 set the bar so much. It just changed the game, fighting game, for Mortal Kombat X, Mortal Kombat 11. They've all adapted and tried to incorporate their own style into the game. But Mortal Kombat 9, so superior. So superior. Last but not least, Mortal Kombat Trilogy. Now this game, holy moly, man. And this is where I feel like my bias is kicking in and I'm trying so hard. I feel like, honestly, maybe this game goes down here, but I don't know. I think it might actually go up to number one, and I'll explain. Like I said, we got introduced to Mortal Kombat 3. A lot of people were very disappointed because of the roster. Like, the gameplay mechanics are amazing, but the roster was lacking. There's a lot of characters that weren't brought into the game, right? Then they brought in Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3. They brought in new maps, they changed a little bit of the gameplay mechanics, and they brought in new characters. Awesome, sweet, what everybody loved. And boom, they dropped in Mortal Kombat Trilogy. And they said, you know what, screw it. We're giving you every single character. We're giving you all the bosses, kind of like Mortal Kombat Armageddon, but we still had all these great fatalities. We still had all these great maps. We still had all this great gameplay. It was fast paced. It changed the game from Mortal Kombat 2 to Mortal Kombat Trilogy. It was just absolutely ridiculous. I remember playing this game with my uncle, and boy, oh boy, that man would literally choose Motaro and kick the crap out of me in that game every single time I played it. There was no chance I was ever winning if he ever picked Motaro, Goro, Kintaro, or Shao Kahn. There was no way in heck I was ever winning. This game was so amazing with the size of the roster, with the characters in this game, with the gameplay mechanics. It just changed everything from Mortal Kombat 2 to Mortal Kombat Trilogy. It was amazing. And it's definitely a classic. It might have a little bit of bias because, you know, I have a little bit of bias. It might go down here. It could be 3. But I'm like, you know, I said I wasn't trying to be biased, but I might be a little bit biased right now. But this is the final tier list right here, guys. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comment section below what your guys' top 5 or top 3 Mortal Kombat games are, and go into detail. Why is it your top 3 games or top 5 games? I'd love to hear from you guys which games are your top 3 and top 5. But right here, here's my S tier. We have number 1, Mortal Kombat Trilogy, number 2, Mortal Kombat 9, number 3, Mortal Kombat Deception, number 4, Mortal Kombat 11, number 5, Mortal Kombat X, number 6, Shaolin Monks, number 7, Mortal Kombat 2. I've had an amazing time making this tier list. It was so hard to make this tier list though. Once I got into the A and the S tier list, it got really, really hard. It got really, really difficult, honestly. I'm even thinking right now to even change some of this stuff from like switching this to here, like maybe even put Mortal Kombat 3 or Mortal Kombat 9 at number 3. I don't know. It's very hard. Like, these three can be interchanged so easily. It could be interchanged so damn easily. But I don't know. What are your guys' thoughts? Let me know in the comment section below. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like, comment, subscribe, share the video, follow the Instagram page at The Island Boys, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Shoots.